Hello and welcome back to a new video after a long, long time. If you even remember me. Because I have been gone since March. Basically, after I finished uploading my Shadow of Gold reading vlog, I vanished again. Because then all of the corona stuff started happening and we went into lockdown and we are in another light lockdown in Germany right now again. And yeah, somehow with this my whole reading mood just vanished, or not my reading mood vanished, because I actually read a lot of books in the first month after the lockdown happened. But yeah, I certainly didn't have the motivation to film any of this. And this is a thing I'm struggling right now with a lot in my mind. I don't know if I want to get into this right now or if I will tell you something about what I'm struggling later in this video, but we'll see. But I thought I would show you, before we are starting this reading vlog, all the books I read in the month after the first lockdown happened. Because, like I said, there were a lot of books. But yeah, I will not go too deep into the synopsis or anything, because I literally don't remember much of these books, because I read them months ago. So yeah, this is a recurring theme in my wrap-ups. I feel like when I start doing this again. So I will just show you the books I read. The first book, and I don't even know if this really was the first book I read, I will just show you the books in the way I stuck them up inside me. So yeah, I read The Kiss of Deception. Then I read The Savage Song by Victoria Schwab and Our Dark Dead by Victoria Schwab. And I needed to reread this before I read this, because as I started reading this, I noticed that I couldn't remember really anything which happened in the first book. So I decided to reread this book again, and I guess I flew through this book. This is all what I can remember, that I finished it a lot faster than I thought I would. And then I guess I flew through this rather big book as well. I guess I finished it in 2 days or something like that, or maybe even just, no, 2 days. I guess it was 2 days, not 1 day. 1 day would have been crazy if I finished this book in 1 day. And then, I don't even know if I showed you this book already in the wrap-up I did at the beginning of the year, so I will just show you it again. And the book is What I Lost by Alexandra Ballard. I'm so sorry, but you know, I'm not good with pronouncing names. And this book is about an eating disorder. That's all I can remember about this book. And except that I liked it. And then I read a German book. And this is Constellation by Claudia Gray. Or I don't think this is a German book. I think it is just translated into German. If I can find the English version of it, I will link the English version down below for you, so you can check it out what it is about, but it is a futuristic book. And yes, I really, really liked it, and I can remember that I wanted to reread it right after I finished it. And if I want to reread a book, then this means it is really, really good. Yes, I can't wait to read the sequel. Even when I don't know when I will get to it, but I can't wait to read the sequel. And then I finally read the book I bought 2 years ago in Canada. And this is What If It's Us by Becca Albertalli and Adam Silvera. And yes, I like this book as well. It was cute and sad at the same time at some parts. And then I have other books I just need to grab right now. And then I have two other German books which are translated into German. This is the fourth and fifth book, I'm not sure if this is the right order of the books, from the Seven Sisters series by Lucinda Riley. If you have watched my channel, then you know that these are the books my sister gives me each Christmas. So I guess she will give me the sixth book this Christmas. And yeah, so this means I just have one book left in the series after I read the sixth one. And yes, I like them, and I'm really glad that my sister gives them to me for Christmas, so I don't have to buy them. I read a mental health book, and this is Under Rose Tinted Skies by Louise Gornal. And yes, this is about Nora, and Nora has anxiety. I have to say, I really liked it, and sometimes for the book, I sometimes thought if I could have a little bit of anxiety as well, but maybe it was just the time when I read this, because it was right after the lockdown, so maybe this is just the whole anxious feeling which probably everyone was feeling at this time. Liked it even when I don't know if this is an accurate representation of anxiety, because I never really suffered from anxiety. And then I guess the last book I read was Everless by Sarah Holland. And this book is about blood magic, and the daughter Jules goes to the palace to pay off the debt of her father, so her father doesn't need to spend all his blood to pay the debts. Kinda. I don't know. I don't know. I'm completely out of this. Out of this making videos in English, so bear with me and my English, please. This is the first book in a trilogy, I guess. And yes, like for any other book I read, I like this as well, and I want to read the sequel to it, because I want to know what will happening to Jules next. Yes, that was my little wrap-up from the books I read months ago. And now the book which brought me back into the reading mood was The Nemesis by S.J. Kincaid. And I don't know if you followed me since I read The Diabolik, but I love The Diabolik. And I love The Empresses, and this book, even when it is the third book, didn't disappoint me at all. It hurt so much at some points, and there were twists and turns I didn't expect again, and Oh my god, the story between Tyrus and Nemesis. It hurts. It hurt my freaking heart so much that I really thought at one point in the book, okay, I'm done with this. I can't read a book. I can't finish this because it was just too much trouble for my heart. I couldn't take it anymore, but yes, I finished it, and I'm glad that I finished it, but, oh boy, my heart was through the ringer after this book, and because this was such a heavy hit to my heart, I decided to read now after this book. Finally, I have to say to this, because I have this book since it came out. And this is The Lost Book of the Wild by Cassandra Clare and Wenzel Chu. And yes, I decided to read this because I really hope that this will be more happy and light than Nemesis. Because after the Nemesis, I really need now something more happy and light. And this is the second book in the Atlas Curse series. I don't think I need to say this on this channel anymore, but I just love Cass's books. I love Harry Potter and the series. I love it! And yes, so I'm double excited to read this book. For one, because I hope it will be more happy and light than Nemesis. And the other part is short because it is Cassandra Clare and I will be diving back into the Shadowhunter world. And yes, that's my plan for this reading vlog. I want to read The Lost Book of the Wild and finish it and take you with me while I read it. And then I started today morning while I got ready an audiobook. And this audiobook was Girl Stop Apologizing by Rachel Hollis, if I remember the author correctly. Because I just got an offer from Audible where I could get two audiobooks for free. And I just needed to jump on this deal because if you can get audiobooks for free, yes, please. But yeah, I'm not really far into this audiobook. I'm still in chapter 1 and I guess I just have listened to 20 minutes of the audiobook. So we will see how I like it. But yeah, then I guess I will update you after I read some more, even when I don't know when I will read some more, because right now I just want to ask a friend if we want to meet over Discord again and play a video game which was released tonight or yesterday night. And yes, she will be playing and I will be watching, but yeah, I guess I will run. I will do that now. I will ask her and then if she has time, we will play, and if not, I don't know. Maybe I will start reading The Lost Book of the Wild. We'll see. The last thing you saw yesterday was my class at uni, and then I wanted to read something, but yeah, I didn't feel up to it mentally yesterday because mentally was a rough day yesterday. It was really, really rough after the class. The class didn't have anything to do with it, but just it was rough. But yeah, actually I read on Tuesday I read a lot of the Lost Book of the Wild, and I'm there now. I don't know if you can even see that. I haven't read as much as I thought I would, but I loved it. I laughed out loud so much during reading this part already, and I can just feel that this book will be a good book and that it will be happy and fun. Hopefully, even when something happened with Magnus, which is a bit disturbing, and I don't know how this will go, but yeah, at least I know that he is not going to die. But yeah, it is a bit disturbing, and I just found out something about all of the TMI characters I didn't know about something we as readers just find out in Queen of Air and Darkness. And I have to say, I was a little bit pissed that we had to wait until Queen of Air and Darkness until we got to know this truth. I would say, if you don't want to get spoiled for something which happens in Queen of Air and Darkness, don't read the Lost Book of the Wild before you read Queen of Air and Darkness. And for sure, don't read this book before you haven't finished City of Heavenly Fire, because this book plays 2 years after City of Heavenly Fire. So this would be a huge spoiler for everyone who hasn't read City of Heavenly Fire. But like I said, I loved it, and today afternoon I will read more, but now I will first make me something to eat. And then we will continue reading. And what I showed you in the clip as I started reading was the inside of the dust jacket of this book. And this is so beautiful. I mean, look at it. This is just beautiful. I love it, and I guess you could even turn this around and make this the desk jacket. But yeah, I don't know if I'm skilled enough to flip this around without ripping it. So I will just leave it as it is, because I mean, this side is beautiful as well. But yeah, now, like I said, I will make me something to eat, and then we will read.
I'm not afraid to die. think this in my phone now since my camera is full right now and I don't really have the motivation to clear out stuff from it. So yeah, but I'm halfway done with the last book of the white now and oh boy, what is happening to me? This is getting scary because I mean I know that Magnus will survive this because he still lives in the Dark Artifices, but yeah, this doesn't make it less scary with what is happening right now. I'm really interested to see how all of this will resolve, but yeah, I'm going to bed now because I'm going to visit my sister tomorrow because she moved out this year after she was done with school and is starting now in another town. So we will visit her tomorrow and yes, so I will go to bed now and on the drive tomorrow I will continue reading this because I really want to know what is going to happen now.
What happens to a character or what happened to a character, and yes, something happened to Simon and how he reacts to what happened afterwards is just my heart. I also pre-ordered Chain of Iron this week. I don't know how it is, could slip my mind that Chain of Iron will come out at the beginning of next year, but it did. But no, I pre-ordered it and yes, I can't wait to read Shining Chain of Iron, even when I know that it will destroy me emotionally because everyone of Kisses big series that destroy me emotionally and chain of gold destroy me emotionally as well. And on the topic of chain of gold, I still have the review for chain of gold on my laptop. So, I don't know. Would you like to see this review? Or are you over the review for chain of gold? Because if you still want to watch my chain of gold review, I can upload it here and you can watch it. So, please let me know if you would like to watch it. But, yeah, I really, really like this series, the Eldest Curses series, because it is like I said, the perfect mixture of hurt and funniness, because yes, you can be hurt in one moment and then the next moment a character says something funny and you just start laughing. So yes, I would say this series is the only series by Cassie where I'm not totally emotionally destroyed. Because it just keeps a really nice balance between the emotional scenes and the funny scenes. And yes, now my camera is flashing red or my battery is flashing red. So I guess I should go and continue reading this.
And now I'm on my phone again because I forgot something to say right now. Because I just read the first sentence of the next chapter and I'm like, Magnus, what are you planning and what are you doing? Sorry, that's Facebook, the bing you are hearing. But yes, I'm just thinking, Magnus, what are you doing and what are you planning? But yes, what I also forgot to say before, in the clip before, was that I think it is great that you can read this series even when you know that Magnus will be alright and that everyone else will be alright because of the dark artifices and so on, that you still want to read the series and are getting sucked into the story just because you want to know how they managed to escape this mess. And that's something I don't experience often with a lot of series, that I really want to read the other series even when I know that the main characters will be fine. Because then I think, yeah, okay, I know that I will be fine, so why do I need to read this story between the main series? But yeah, that's something I'm really liking about Kiss's writing style and Kiss's books, because I'm just getting sucked into every book. And yeah, please let me know if you have a series where you feel like this as well.
Thank you.
Lost Book of the White yesterday evening, and now I just have the short story left in it, which I'm very excited to read since it is a short story about Tessa and Cem. And yes, I have to say, in the end, something happened I didn't expect would happen. And even when I knew that the characters would be fine, I had a few moments of doubt if they really, really would be fine. Because, like I said, something happened I really didn't expect it to happen. And in the epilogue, at the end of the epilogue, the humans are talking about something I'm not happy about. I'm really not happy about what they are talking. And yes, now I'm afraid how the last book of the series will play out, because the last sentence was like, please, what? No? Please, no? But yeah, now I'm excited to read the short story, and like I said, I really, really like this book, but I honestly hadn't even a doubt about it that I would like it, because it is a book within the Shadowhunter world, and yes, I just love the Shadowhunter world, and I will be so sad when Cassie stops writing in it, and yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do then. But until then, we have a few years left with the Shadowhunters and so on, so I will enjoy the time we have left and just read every book in this world, and yes, now I will read the short story, and after that I'm going to check in with you again. So I finished The Lost Book of the White, and the short story about Tessa and Cem was really, really nice and heartwarming, and I'm not gonna lie, I had a few tears of happiness in my eyes as I read this short story, because it was just... But yeah, I just noticed that I have another book I would like to show you, and I haven't unboxed it yet. And yes, but I guess I will do that tomorrow morning, and then I will end this vlog. So yeah, see you tomorrow morning with the unboxing. Good morning, and like I promised, here is the book haul with one book. And when I open this, you will probably wonder why I haven't unpacked this already, because I was literally obsessed with this book series as the movies came out, but yeah, I haven't unboxed it yet, so I will do this now with you. Snakes by Susan Collins, the prequel, I think, to The Hunger Games. And yes, I really don't know why I haven't unboxed it yet, because I was literally obsessed with The Hunger Games. My obsession level was almost the obsession level I have with the Mortal Instruments now. But just almost. Not quite this obsessed, but almost. So, yeah, I'm shocked myself that I haven't unboxed this book yet. But I don't even know what this book is about. I just know that it is about President Snow, as President Snow was younger, or a kid, maybe even. Yeah, I have no idea. Maybe I should have looked this book up before I unboxed it so I could talk more about it, but yes, I have heard mixed reviews, I guess, about it, but I'm just excited to dive back into the Hunger Games world with this book, and I so hope that I will like it. I really, really hope that I will like it. But now let's look what it is about. It is the morning of the reaping that will kick off the 10th annual Hunger Games. In the capital, 18-year-old Cornelius Snow, oh gosh, I'm sorry, I butchered Snow's first name, is preparing for his one shot at Chloe as a mentor in the games. The once mighty House of Snow has fallen on hard times. Its fate hanging on the slender chance that Cornelius will be able to outmatch, outwit, and outmaneuver his fellow students to mentor the winning tribute. The odds are against him. He's been given the humiliating assignment of mentoring the female tribute from District 12, the lowest of the low. Their fates are now completely intertwined. Every choice Cornelius makes could lead to favor or failure, triumph or ruin. Inside the arena, it will be a fight to death. Outside the arena, Cornelius starts to feel for his doom tribute and must weigh his need to follow the rules against his desire to survive no matter what it takes. So I was right. It is about a younger Snow. And Snow is a mentor, apparently, in this book for District 12. For District 12. Interesting. So, we will see how I like it. If you want me to make a reading vlog while I'm reading this, then please comment this down below and I will do it. But now to the topic I just brushed over at the beginning of this vlog. And this is why I vanished for all these months. Or why I keep vanishing and reappearing. From time to time on this channel, and yeah, that's mostly when I'm not in the mood to read anything, and then I noticed, okay, when I'm not in the mood to read anything, then I suddenly have nothing to talk about on this channel, because I don't know if you would be interested in just seeing my day-to-day life, or if you are just here because of the book content. So yeah, it would be nice if you would let me know that as well, if you are just here for the book content or if you wouldn't mind if I would upload some day-to-day life vlogs and things I'm doing in my life except from reading. Because like I said, I seem to dip out of the reading mood quite a lot in last month. And I honestly feel bad when I just vanish from this channel because I just don't have anything to talk about because I'm not reading anything. And then I just abandoned this channel and you are just sitting here waiting for more content and there is no more content because I'm not really in the reading mood at the moment. And yes, I'm really, really sorry for that, but yeah, maybe if you would be interested to see more of my day-to-day life, I could just include this into this channel a bit more, but of course book content would be my priority on this channel because I have another channel where I just have my live content stuff. But yeah, just let me know if you just want to see a strict book content or if you would be fine if I include stuff from my normal life which is not bookish related or book related in any kind of way on here as well. Because this would help me in deciding what I want to do on here. And yes, please let me know if you still want to have the Shine of Gold review or not, because if you want to have it, I will upload it, like I said in the vlog already, And yes, let me know if you want to have a reading vlog about this book. And now I need to go because I have my class now for you. Oh, and yes, I really hope you liked this reading vlog. And if you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you don't want to miss another video of mine, then please subscribe to the channel. And then I will see you in my next one. Bye!